manufacturer presents the idea of resizing arrays so that we can implement an ADT bag that is resizable. An array has a fixed size, which is chosen by either the programmer or the user before the array is created. A fixed size array is like a classroom. If the room contains 40 desks, but only 30 students, we waste 10 desks. If 40 students are taking the course, the room is full and cannot accommodate anyone else. Likewise, if we do not use all the locations in an array, we waste memory. If we need more, we're out of luck. Using a fixed size array to implement the ADT bag limits the size of the bag. When the array, and hence the bag, becomes full, the method isFull returns true, and any future calls to the method add return false. We cannot add any other items to our bag. Some applications can use a bag or collection that has a limited capacity. For other applications, however, we need the size of the collection to grow without bound. One strategy for accommodating additional students for when a classroom is full is to move to a larger room. We can do something similar when our array becomes full. We create a new array of twice the capacity of the old one, and then we copy the entries from our original full array to the new array. By copying the data from the original smaller array to the beginning of the new larger array, the result is like expanding the original array. The only glitch in this scheme is the name of the new array. You want it to be the same as the name of the old array. Let's look at how we can accomplish this. Here is our original array filled to capacity with 5 entries. First, we create an alias to this array. At this point, both old data and my data reference the same 5-element array. We do this so that we do not lose our reference to the original array in the next step. We can now create a new array that is double the size of the original, 2 times its length. We assign my data to reference this array. Notice that if we did not assign old data to reference the original array prior to the statement, we would lose our array since we would not have any variable referencing it. Next, we copy each of the elements from the original array to the new double size array. Last, we set old data to null. This removes any reference to the original array, and so it is marked for collection. An alternative method is to use the copyOf method in the Java class arrays to copy the entries in the original array to a new double size array and then assign that array to my data. Resizing an array is not as attractive as it might first seem. Each time you expand the size of an array, you must copy its contents. As the size of the array increases, each time you expand it, the number of copies required doubles. So expanding a 100-element array to 200 elements requires 100 copies. If the new array needs to be expanded, the next expansion requires 200 copies. Also, once an array is doubled in size, we cannot reduce its size, so the extra array elements may be wasted. Let's see how resizing arrays can help us create a bag that expands in size when needed. We're going to create a resizable bag class that doubles in capacity when the array bag becomes full. This can be accomplished with only a few small changes. Let's change the name of the class to resizable array bag so we can distinguish between our two implementations. We must also change the names of the constructors to match the new class name. We should change the name of the constant default capacity to default initial capacity. Although it is not absolutely necessary, this change clarifies the new purpose of the constant, since the bag's capacity will increase as needed. We have to make the same change in the default constructor, which uses this constant. Since we must be able to reassign the data field to a new array when it is resized, we have to remove the modifier final from the declaration of the array bag. Since we are resizing the bag each time the array is filled to capacity, the bag will never be full, so the method isFull should always return false. In our implementation of the method add in array bag, most of our statements were used to ensure the bag was not full or had sufficient capacity before we performed the add. Only 2 lines of code were actually needed to add an entry to our bag. Since now the isFull method always returns true, the other statements are unnecessary, so we can remove them. Instead, we can define a private method to make this check and resize the array bag if necessary. Let's name the method insureCapacity. Also, since the bag will always have enough capacity for an add, the method will never return false, so it will return true at the end. Our private helper method insureCapacity should check to see if the array is filled, and if so, double its capacity using one of the algorithms we discussed earlier. So, with only a few minor changes, we have an ADT bag implementation that uses an array to store the items in the bag, but always has enough capacity for us to add additional items.